The Queen is rumored to be stepping down in the 2 years when she is 95. She has become the oldest and longest serving British monarch in history, since starting her reign in 1952. Royal experts now say that Her Majesty will likely hand the throne to Charles and will want the transition to be as smoother as possible. I understand the Queen has given the matter considerable thought and believes that, if she is still alive at 95, she will seriously consider passing the reign to Charles, says author Robert Jobson. Her Majesty is mindful of her age and wants to make sure, when the time comes, the transition of the crown is seamless. She would never want to do anything, or be seen to do anything, that would harm the monarchy, and the includes going on too long, a senior aide told Jobson. If she felt her age was in any way damaging the monarchy, she would act accordingly. Alternatively, royals expert Phil Dampier has speculated that the Queen could also bring in Charles to act as regent if she is unable to perform her royal duties. There is talk that when she reaches 95 in a couple of years she may slow down and possibly the Regency Act will be brought in, Phil told Yahoo's The Royal Box. She will still be Queen but Prince Charles will, in fact, take over most of the duties. If this were to occur, Prince Charles would take on the roles previously looked after by the Queen. He is starting to do that already, being at the state opening in Parliament and the Commonwealth Conference, Phil added. He is starting to take over a lot of the duties and doing the investitures. For the crowning of a new monarch, the Queen will need to either step down or die. In both cases, the natural succession to the title would be Prince Charles. He will then become head of the Commonwealth as stipulated in a statement issued by the Commonwealth in 2018. We recognize the role of the Queen in championing the Commonwealth and its peoples. The next head of the Commonwealth shall be His Royal Highness Prince Charles, the Prince of Wales. This followed the express wishes of the Queen, when she said, "It is my sincere wish that the Commonwealth will continue to offer stability and continuity for future generations, and will decide that one day the Prince of Wales should carry on the important work started by my father in 1949. However, there has been some talk that Prince William could become king if Charles decides to abdicate, due to the public favoring his son in the popularity stakes. But, according to experts, this is unlikely." Royals biographer Penny Junner believes Charles does think he will become king. "I certainly don't think he's preparing to hand over to William or to abdicate himself," she added. "I think he will become king. The Queen is likely to give Prince Charles a new title when it comes to the heir apparent taking over," claims an expert. "This will be to mark the transition of power. Queen Elizabeth has been on the throne since 1952, serving as queen for 67 years. She is likely to stay on the throne until she dies, so we'll give Prince Charles a new title to mark the transition of power," an expert has claimed. This comes after the royal news that Prince Harry's and Duchess Meghan's titles could be changing too, as they are up for debate in the coming month. Queen Elizabeth has served on the throne for the last 67 years and a royal expert has claimed that she isn't going anywhere anytime soon. It is believed that the Queen, who ascended to the throne back in 1952 after her father King George VI passed away, will remain on the throne until she dies, rather than abdicating and passing the crown to her son Prince Charles. However, a royal expert has suggested that to mark the transition of power between her and next in line Charles, the Queen will bestow a new title onto him. Speaking to the Royal Central podcast, royal expert Monique Bloch suggested that the Queen won't follow suit of several other European monarchs, who have passed their crowns onto their descendants. "I think if anything happens, it's more likely she'll make Charles regent instead of completely abdicating," said Ms. Bloch. "I think it's very unlikely that she will abdicate. By making Prince Charles regent, the Queen would be passing on the majority of her royal duties to her 70-year-old son, without losing her role as reigning monarch. This move would mark the transition of power between the mother and son, before Charles would be crowned king after Queen Elizabeth II passes away. The Queen would be able to make the move by triggering the Regency Acts, a series of laws that allows the removal of powers from the monarch to an appointed member of the royal family," should the monarch be unable to carry out their duties.